Hi, welcome back. I'm Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about amortized analysis. But before we start, I'd like to share a small information. We produce every video in two different languages, Hindi as well as in English, so that you can watch the video in your preferred language. And if you have not yet subscribed, kindly press the subscribe button followed by the bell icon so that you'll get all the notifications from this channel. So let us start amortized analysis. Amortized analysis is applied on data structures that support many operations. And the sequence of operations and the multiplicity of each operation on the application specific or associated with the algorithm specific. Classical asymptotic analysis gives worst case analysis on each operation without taking the effect of one operation on the other, whereas amortized analysis focuses on the sequence of operations. Since many operations are involved as a part of the analysis, the objective is to perform efficiently as many operations as possible, leaving very few costly operations. To calculate the amortized analysis operations, we take the average over all the operations. In particular, worst case time of each operation is taken into account to calculate the average cost in the worst case. There are three different approaches available for amortized analysis. The first one is aggregate analysis, second one is accounting method, and the third one is potential method. We'll discuss each and every method one by one. Let us try to discuss some highlights of amortized analysis. Amortized analysis is basically applied to algorithm where an occasional operation is very slow, but most of the operations are faster. We analyze the sequence of operations and guarantee a worst case average time, which is lower than the worst case time of a particular expensive operation. Amortized analysis is applied to algorithm where it is the average performance of each operation in the worst case. And it is concerned with the overall cost of sequence of operations. It doesn't say anything about the cost of a specific operation in that sequence. Other operations are faster. Amortized analysis may consist of operations of cheap, less expensive, and expensive operations. However, it will show the average cost of an operation is cheap. This is different from average case analysis, wherein average argument is taken over all inputs of the specific operation. Inputs are modeled using a suitable probability distribution. In amortized analysis, no probability is involved. Let us take stack data structure as an example to understand amortized analysis. Basically, when we are talking about stack, there are two different operations that is involved, that is push and pop. The third one is there, multiple pop, when more number of data is there in the stack. Let us assume that the size of the stack is S, and when we are doing push of S and X to the stack S with size S, we are pushing element X to the stack. So every time we'll be pushing one element, so that's why for every element it will take order of one time. So to push n element, it will take big O of n time. Pop operation, it pops up or it deletes, it will delete the element which is on the top of the stack. So to delete n element, it will take big O of n times. And for multiple pop, so it will take minimum of s comma k. So the element can be popped is big O of n for k element popped. It means if the size of the stack is s, we can pop k element. So whichever is minimum between s and k, that many pop we can perform. Let us try to understand the aggregate analysis with the help of stack data structure. So in this method, each operation has same cost. Each object can only be popped once per time that it is pushed. There are at most n pushes, so at most n pops are included in the multipop. So therefore the total cost is big O of n the average over n operations, we have big O of 1 per operation. Let us try to understand accounting method for the stack data structure. Now in this method, different operations have different cost. So amortized cost always will be greater than or equal to the actual cost. When actual cost is greater than amortized cost, and the credit can never be negative. Let us take CI, the actual cost of ith operation, and CI dash as amortized cost of ith operation. It means what? Summation of CI dash always will be greater than or equal to CI for all the elements in the stack. Let us say 1 rupees for push and 1 rupees for pop. For amortized cost, 2 rupees for each push operation and 0 rupees for each pop operation. Let us try to understand this. For push operation, the actual cost is 1 rupees and amortized cost is 2 rupees. For pop operation, actual cost will be 1 rupees, but amortized cost will be 0 rupees. And you can see that CI dash is less than CI. For multiple pop, as we already know that the actual cost will be minimum of S and K, and amortized cost will be 0. Here also CI dash, that is the amortized cost, will be less than CI. So the actual cost C is big O of N, and the amortized cost C dash is also big O of N. Let us take the potential method to understand the operation in the stack. In this method, we define a potential function capturing some structural parameter. Let us say D0 is the initial structure of the stack, and DI is the structure after ith operation. And CI is the cost of ith operation, and CI dash is the amortized cost after ith operation. Let phi be the potential function such that phi is a mapping from DI to a real number. It means what? So CI dash is equal to CI plus phi of DI minus phi of DI minus 1. Then phi of DI is what? Is the potential function at the structure DI. And phi DI minus 1 is the potential function at its previous state. If phi of DI minus phi of DI minus 1 is greater than 0, then amortized cost is greater than actual cost. And on the other hand, if phi DI minus phi DI minus 1 is less than 0, then amortized cost is less than the actual cost. And if we take summation on both sides, we'll get phi of DI will always be greater than or equal to phi of D0. So let us try to understand with the help of a numeric example. Let us say phi of DI is the number of objects in the stack S, and phi of D0 is the zero object in the stack. When we are performing a push operation, actual cost is 1. Phi of DI minus phi of DI minus 1, it will become SI plus 1 minus S. If in this case S number of element is there, then at its next state S plus 1 number of element is there. So that's why the difference become 1. Now when we are popping, actual cost will be 1, amortized cost will be 0, and the difference in potential becomes minus 1. When it is actual cost, it is K dash, that is minimum of S and K. And in amortized cost, it becomes 0. But under potential, it will be minus K dash. To find the actual cost, it will take big O of N time. And to find the amortized cost C dash, it will also take big O of N time. I hope you understood it. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Keep watching, keep learning. If you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get all the notification. Please support us by liking, sharing, and commenting on the video. We'll meet in one more video. Till then, take care. Bye.